Okay, so what I have here is a 1989 Nishiki Timbuk 2. For those of you who aren't familiar with Canadian bikes, I don't know exactly how Norco got a hold of the Nishiki name. I believe, much like Raleigh seems to have Raleigh in the UK, Raleigh in the US. I think it was Derby that ran Nishiki and Raleigh and a bunch of others. I always get the corporate ownership of a lot of these old bikes kind of confused. Anyways, Norco had the rights to Nishiki, so you saw a lot of crossover between the frames and components and stuff. Components are fairly obvious, but for the frames and forks, not the color schemes, but the frame and fork and stem and bars and a lot of the other components were very similar between these two brands, with the Norco's Rampage being their top of the line for the year this came out as well. And I guess the reason why this bike is, when I saw it at my friend Jim's house, why it kind of made a big impact on me is, as I head a little closer in here, is that they're Daniel's Bicycle Clearance Company. So for most people, that's not going to mean a whole lot unless you lived in, outside of Vancouver, the Tri-Cities area, Port Moody, Coquitlam, Port Coquitlam. The idea with Daniel's Bicycle Clearance Company, which is the first job I ever worked at, was they would take some of the overproduction or bikes from the previous years, and my first year working there was 1990, but they would take bikes from the previous years that were not sold, and they would have them at basically at kind of fire sale prices compared to whatever the current year and model of bikes was. The location that I worked at, so this is the original, my car, they had two locations, and they were both actually former CAPS locations. I have a lot of, not a lot of memorabilia, but I still have a lot of decals from Daniel's Bicycle Clearance Company. So yeah, it's a small shop. It had a lot of interesting stuff: Cannondales, Nishikis, Norcos, Peugeots. Again, whatever was kind of overstock from the previous years. Anyway, so yeah, 1989, Nishiki bicycles. I guess it took this down, and you'll actually notice the Norco catalog of the same year had a lot of stuff from, I guess, Arizona, the Flat Rock areas. I can't remember, Slick Rock, I mean to say. You can see, from year to year, that was, so you had Biopace, and that was the spec, and then the next year, Height Right, pretty similar frame design with sloping top tube and stuff. But this is what that address there, that's what's there now on Google Maps, is a treasure chest, games and collectibles. I don't know, I haven't been there in a long time. So yeah, that's it. This is the 1989 Nishiki Timbuk 2. Again, other interesting stuff, under the chainstay U-brake, which for the next year was moved to the top of the seat stay because this just collected a lot of mud and dirt. You can still see a lot of stuff that I haven't cleaned off down there. XT Grupo with array of RM20s. These are, oh, they're 36 hole, yikes. That's kind of heavy. One of the first years for Hyperglide. There's our Biopace rings that, make setting your derailleur, front derailleur height kind of annoying. Timbuk2 tires that have not succumbed to ground level ozone and UV damage. Only three main tubes are chromoly, and I don't even believe they're butted, or they would advertise if this was, Tange or whatever. Chromoly fork, they say inch and an eighth, but that's just the fork leg diameter. And no safety dropouts. So for those who don't remember or are unaware, you'd actually see a bulge at the bottom here, so that if your quick release was undone, your wheel would not just drop on the ground like this one will. So, you know, without the safety dropouts there, if you leave your quick release undone, you're going to end up using your face as a brake and activating your dental policy. Same with this hanger here. If for any reason this straddle cable broke, or sorry, the main brake cable broke, you'll also notice this is the 2 mil as opposed to the 1.6 mil that's common now. Without a reflector or this cable hanger here, it would drop onto the tire and launch you over the handlebars. Some of the other interesting kind of, almost not forensics, but looking at the damage that various bikes have seen over the years, and you'll see that this Syncros bar end has completely fractured around the weld. And the other damage, as I was looking over the bike and cleaning it, this is also the last year of 1-inch. After this, everything went 1 1/8. It is an XT headset. It's a well-specced bike, but bikes like this, especially nowadays when XT is worth, significantly more than it was even 5 years ago, they end up being bikes that just get taken apart, and these parts get put on other frames of more value. Anyways, so we've got a SR seat post here, and it's 26.6 further, the welding's nice, but further indicating just how thick and heavy, like these frames, not the frame, but the whole bike was probably in the neighborhood of 28 to 30 pounds. They were a solid 2 pounds heavier than a Rocky Mountain or a Kona. So 26.6. So again, very thick wall. You got a huge gusset here, and you can see just how much overlap that is there. You can see it was brazed, and there's the other part of the tube, the inner part. It's also cracked. So I'm assuming these are, press fit and then glued, but the tolerance here is so severe that over the last, this is 1989, so over the last 33 years, just slowly this has fatigued or broken or seen some other, I don't see any other damage on the frame that would have caused this sort of crack or, again, this bar end to snap off or to be fractured. This side here, no such issues. The welds look good. Syncros didn't, stuff broke that I've seen from Syncros, but not this much. So high profile brakes, U-brake, full XT. I believe this is all 730 stuff. There we go, yeah. So that's my another video. At least this one's under 10 minutes so far. I might pause this and just pull some Norco catalogs out just so you can compare. Okay, so I'm back. I just wanted to show you another Daniel's Bicycle Clearance Company. Again, I don't know if this stuff's super interesting to people. This is my first toolbox that I ever had. And it has, old Suntour and Garnet and Araya. Old Daniel's, and another shop I worked at, the Ridge Bike Shop. And, just random decals from over the years. But the point, I guess, that I wanted to make about Nishiki here and its connection with Norco, especially back in the 80s and such. And I don't know a ton of history about Norco. I mean, if you ever want to see, I guess, some popular, where it actually kind of made it into a movie, check out the movie Rad. They have the Norco bicycle racing team there with the Norco van and all that sort of stuff. I think that was shot in Alberta. I can't remember exactly what city, but Rad, the BMX movie. Check it out, and you'll see the Norco racing team. Anyways, if you turn over the back here, you can see Norco products. As we go into Norco 1989, you take a look at this quick release and seat post and the fork and everything, and you look at the Rampage, and you see a lot of similar. You see the same stem with the roller on it. You see pretty much the same rims, exactly the same spec, same Veta saddle, same seat post. It's kind of crazy. Same roller stem, on these two bikes. And yeah, anyways, I just find some of these old bikes kind of interesting. Their first aluminum bike, which was, yeah, I can't remember if it was glued or not. It's a weirdly strange bike. There you go, Norco products, you know. And then I also mentioned Fiori, which, I don't know, interesting paint jobs and Alfa Romeo there. And you can see they had the Extreme. I haven't seen one of these bikes in forever, but you see the same seat post, the same stem, the same, you know, obviously with the Shimano spec, you can see the same crank and stuff like that. But, and you turn it over, I'll just go through this real quickly because Fiori's a real interesting brand. You know, you see this Fiori here is basically the same as this Norco. Let me just grab that page here real quickly. There's just so much product sharing going on between these. I mean, I don't know. I just find this kind of funny. Exactly the same spec. The only difference is basically the color scheme. And I believe Nishiki had one very similar to that too, utilizing the they utilized the Dior name because Dior 6-speed was quite a bit you know, less expensive than the 21-speed stuff. Anyways, I think I'm a little out of my depth with that. Yeah, so this is kind of the video I wanted to make, was a brief video about my first job in a bike shop when I was 15. Lots of the different older bikes that were sold there, and how this company Norco would, you know, utilize some of the higher end stuff from Shimano from the previous years to you know, spec out their more entry level bikes. One of the things I should probably go over with this Nishiki is, for anybody who might have one, is some of the specs, just so you can see what I'm speaking of. Let me get over to yeah, here we go. There's a Timbuk 2. So I guess it's a 16-inch. It's Japanese tubing, apparently. Monostay. It's got a racing bar and racing grips that are also have seen better days. Unfortunately, they're both cracked and destroyed. And yeah, 1228, pretty standard, you know, just basic Shimano XT stuff. Anyways, yeah, my first job in a bike shop, for what that's worth. Any other specs here? No, that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next thing I find interesting and feel like uploading. Take care.